Today on Podcast Rock City Live, we're 8 years old. We're 8 years old. And the one of the topics that we're going to talk about today is the fact that a podcaster is trying to get President Barack Obama and President Trump together on the show so they can talk out things and make life better here in the United States, offering $5 million. So what we here at Podcast Rock City have decided to do is try to get Peter Criss, Paul Stanley, Gene Simmons, and Ace Frehley all on our show, and we are prepared to offer
Podcast Rock City.
What's up, everybody? Joe here from Podcast Rock City, and with me is Mr. Sonny Hollywood Pooney.
Cents.
Yes.
Rupees.
We're going to get to that in just a second. For those of you guys out there, Jody, he's on his way here. He's stuck in St. Louis traffic. He sent me a message. He's like, I'm going to be a few minutes late. I can't get out of the stupid traffic. He'll be here. Today is our 8th birthday. If you would have told me 8 years ago that when I started this, that I would still be doing this, I would have never believed you. I was only able, with the original few people that did the show, I was only able to get them to do a few shows with me before I think they got bored. Or I'm not really sure the whole thing, but I think they just got bored. But, you know, I wanted to keep going and like you guys all know, and I just kept going, and luckily it's been awesome. Sonny, you've been with us how many years now? Four?
Four. Yeah, I've been on half the ride. You know, I'll tell you, having another podcast too, it's not easy to do all the time. And like, if you take a break and you say, oh, I'm going to take a 3-month break and come back, most of the people don't come back. You know, we were doing a ton of editing, all that kind of stuff. We kind of laid off the editing a little bit to make it a little bit easier, but still, you got to get together every week. You still got to come up with something. You got to make it somewhat interesting. You still got to talk for an hour. That's not, no matter how bad you want it, the same dessert every week doesn't always work.
Right. Fortunately for us, people tend to like our shows. Sometimes I get a little crap from people, depending on what we say or whatever. But that's okay. This is your show too. You know, we do not try to pretend that we are KISS scholars. We don't try to pretend that, you know. There are other podcasts like KISS FAQ. I mean, they've written books. They have that kind of knowledge. They've done the deep reading. We've done fan reading, right? We've had the magazines. We've watched the movies. We've watched the documentaries. You know, Julian's got his shit down when it comes to FAQ. He knows. I mean, you don't just have that website without knowing your stuff, right? So, you know, and then Matt, like Matt Porter, he's a fan. He does a fan show, which makes the KISS Room amazing. Once a month, he gets on there and blows shit out of a cannon, and it's amazing. So that's the thing about our show. All the messages, I get emails every week, and it's always the same thing. I feel like I'm hanging out with my buddies when we're talking about KISS. And the best thing now is the show is live on YouTube and Facebook, so you can be part of the conversation. You agree?
Yeah, and I think we got a good mix of, you know, we've got the fanboy, you, and then we've got a few that can be critical, right? I can be critical at times. I think Joey jumps in and out of it, depending on if he has to be. I think he's critical of some of the decisions maybe made, but he kind of plays fanboy too a little bit. And then Jody is probably more on my side. So we got kind of a good mix of, you know, it's not like, what'd you think about Crazy Nights? I love Crazy Nights. You know, it's not right. The same thing all the time, which I think people enjoy. I think the other thing that worked for us, and I can only really speak for the last 4 years, is It's nice to be able to do the same thing for 8 years with the same folks. It might have been an advantage to have a few changes along the way to keep it fresh, you know, whether it's Andrew for a while, whether it's Joey now, whatever those changes are. It's just like any other sitcom you ever watch for a long period of time. There was new characters, a few things changed. You know, they saw maybe ratings starting to drop off and they added so-and-so storyline. Same deal.
Well, I really appreciate all the hello to everybody that's listening. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate all the nice birthday cakes you guys are sending us, and the happy birthdays and the happy anniversaries. You know, stick around, man. We still look, the tour ain't over, and then we still got a little bit to talk about once the tour is over, because obviously there's going to be something going on, right?
I think it gets more interesting after the tour is over. I'll be honest and say, the tour going on is actually boring because they have nothing going on except for the tour. Tour gets over. Now we're talking 2.0. We're talking, you know, do people start taking shots at each other because Peter and Ace and Vinny have nothing to lose now and there is no touring? Like, is there a Vegas residency? Like, there's all kinds of things we can talk about afterwards.
No, it's true. I don't know what that comment means. The caption censored the word crap. That's funny. I don't know. But, you know, I started this show with a couple of friends, including Lee, who's the goddess of thunder, Lee Westy, who was in what I think it might have been the first ever all-girl Kiss tribute band. And they were pretty good. And then she was in a all-girl Van Halen tribute band called Sheruption. That's a pretty good name.
Yeah.
And she's a great bass player, man. She played in a band called Iron Mullet, which was like all Maiden and Dio and stuff like that. And that was killer. But you know, people, they start doing something and then they go, I don't really want to do that anymore. And that's fine. I've actually got a message from her saying, you know, you could use a girl on the show. And that still may happen. But right now we're having fun. But, and then Joel,
Joel, that's why people start a Kiss podcast, is because they have opinions that they can't share with anybody. So when you're listening to other podcasts, you're just hearing everybody else's opinion. And at times you'll agree with me, and at times you'll agree with Joey. I don't know why you would do that. And then at times you would agree with Joe. But when you have your own podcast, then you've got a bunch of, you can do some like emotional, just dumping of all the thoughts you got, you know. It can be, I don't know, if nobody's listening, is it fun to do? I don't know. Luckily, we've got listeners, so I don't have to worry about that.
Yeah. You know, and that's the thing. When we first started out 8 years ago, there was the Kiss. Let's see. There was the Kiss Room. There was the Podkist, which was, I think, the original. There was Creatures of the net with Cassius Morris. If you guys don't know who Cassius is, go check it out. That kid, he still loves Kiss as much as anything, but he's making it. He's going to be in the big time. There was Three Sides of the Coin, and there was Kistery Science Theater. And I think that's it. And I'm sorry if I left anybody out. But it was 8 years ago. You know, so we were in there. We were one of the six or seven, and a couple of them have gone, you know, different directions. A couple of them have stopped. A couple of them are still going strong. You know, Three Sides, the Podkist, Kiss Room, they're all still going strong. And I will tell you that I've said this 100 times. I always go back and listen to Kistery Science Theater shows that I haven't seen or heard, because they're the GOAT, man. They're the greatest of all time. I don't care who's listening, what people are saying. I'm on this show, and my opinion is Kistery Science Theater, as far as the Kiss podcast goes, greatest of all time. You know, but now there's so many more. There's so many more. You know, they're shouted out Loudcast. Who else is new? Who else? I mean, there's a couple that just start. I just started watching them and I can't think of their names, but they do a show on YouTube right now. There's probably about 50. Wouldn't you say?
Oh, easy. There's a couple out there that are just doing Kiss album reviews. There's tons. I couldn't keep up for a while. And then I had to kind of back off of it because for us, having this avenue to talk about Kiss, sometimes listening to a lot of other Kiss podcasts kind of burns you out a little bit, right? So
yeah, right.
There's a few tried and true that I still listen to, but I don't listen to all 50. That's for sure, because I can't just listen to Kiss.
Yeah, it's so hard. It's so hard to just keep up. But I'll tell you this: I will get asked about Kiss by clients of mine. That'll be like, I'm wearing a Kiss shirt, and then somebody will walk in and go, oh, you're a Kiss fan. And I'll talk, cause I'm at my business and they want to talk Kiss. I'll talk Kiss. But Karen, who, if you guys don't know, and I think you do, my girlfriend, and I have one, and it's really amazing, actually.
And she's real.
She was here today, and I was looking at her going, I don't know why you have anything to do with me. And I've said that 100 times, but, she will tell you that we'll be out in public and somebody will see me wearing a Kiss shirt or a hoodie or something. And they'll go, hey, you're a Kiss fan. And I'll go, she is. She bought this for me and I'm just wearing it. I'm so afraid they're going to be like, I saw a man in 1979 and Gene Simmons pointed at me. And I pointed back at him. And there's Jody.
Hey, fellas.
Happy birthday.
You too, man. Am I lagging again? Fuck.
No. No.
No? Okay, cool.
Okay, wait. Now you are.
Let me do something real quick. I'll be right back.
Okay. So, I don't know if you guys are all the same way. It's like talking about Kiss, and then, you know, you feel like you're repeating yourself a lot. And for me, I want to tell people, hey, listen, why don't you just watch this? Here's a card. Watch the show and see.
I'm careful what shirts I wear on what days. Like when I'm not watching it, so what'll happen, you know, I live in the Bay Area, right? So I'll go out to the grocery store or whatever, and I'll just throw whatever shirt on. I'll be at the grocery store. Somebody goes, great game last night, huh? And I'm like, what? And I look down, and I'm wearing a Giants shirt, and they're a huge Giants fan. Dude, I just bought the Giants shirt because I live in San Francisco. Like, I watch it a little bit, and yeah, I'm a Giants fan, but I'm not a baseball super nerd, right? I don't know the scores all the time. So I'm careful. Like, I'll just wear plain black shirts if I don't want anybody, like, asking me any questions.
Yeah, you know, on here, this is where we do it. But, you know, and then, you know, and I'm not complaining, though, because it's really awesome to be able to talk about something that you love so much, you know? Here's a question. Hey guys, this would have been a cool solo album. Ace and Paul team up for one hell of a kick-ass album. I agree. Paul has to sing though. The best thing is I put that comment in. That's important. The best thing is the best thing Paul has done since the Bullshit Psycho and Ace and Paul.
Ace can sing some of those songs if Paul writes the melody. Right. So because Paul would be careful to write a melody that he can do well.
No, I agree. You there, Jodi? You're silent. You're silent. He'll figure it out. So that's the kind of thing that happens. So you know what? While Jody's working that out, let's go ahead and I wanted to talk about something else before we start talking about the history of this show, which some of you guys know, but I'm gonna ask a lot of questions to Jody and to Sonny, and so let's go ahead and get to this piece of news.
Podcast Rock City News.
All right, so you heard me talking about it as we started the show earlier. There is a podcaster that's actually offering President Obama and President Trump. Notice how I put president in front of both of them because they were. because I had somebody one time say, why don't you say President Obama? And I was like, I say Trump. There you are.
I think I'm still out.
No, you're good.
Am I?
Yes, you're good. Okay. So, okay. All right. So here, I want you to catch up on what we got going on. So there's a podcaster that has offered President Obama and President Trump $5 million to get together and to wipe the slate clean and have a talk, right? So I say, now I don't have $5 million, but I'm going to go ahead and put this out there. Paul Stanley, Gene Simmons, Ace Frehley, Peter Criss, the other guy, that one dude with the thing on the center, with the circle, fuck him. But those other four guys, you guys could come on the show and we will help you navigate peace. I'm literally putting this out there. You guys out there that listen to this show, send them the letters and say, hey, Podcast Rock City is asking you guys to come on the show so they could moderate some peace. Here's the reason why. And I don't know how you guys feel. I'm way more of a fanboy than you guys are. I love them like they're my parents, okay? And I don't mean that 100% literally. You know what I'm saying? I feel like a child in a divorce. Okay? And by them not getting along, it hurts my heart. Right? It hurts my heart. Now, when I say that, you guys out there listening and you guys and Jody, like you and Sonny, Jody, let me ask you, do you understand where I'm coming from when I say that?
No, not at all, dude. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, of course I do. But I mean, what kind of peace are you talking about? What's going on? I guess I missed part of it.
No, eight years
and I still can't get on the internet.
So like I said, this guy, you know, the country is split. So this guy basically offered $5 million to President Obama and President Trump to get together on his show and just talk. And let's see if we can't heal the issues of the country, you know. And I'm saying without the money, because $5 million is a lot of money. And I only have about 3.7 anyway. But I say we could do the same thing. Peter yeah. and Ace, but just think about this.
Oh, okay, with Kiss. I thought you meant have us talk to Trump and Obama. I'm like, wait, no.
Hey, it's President Trump and President Obama. Watch it.
Because if you want peace in America, you got to get rid of the Federal Reserve. It's that simple.
All right, here we go. New conversation. Jody, that's
Sorry.
For our political podcast that we do
yeah.
on Mondays.
Mm-hmm.
That would not be good. So I'm really legit. Look at this face. I'm telling you right now.
Oh shit.
Did your light go out?
Yeah, I just knocked it over. Lovely.
Stanley, Gene Simmons, Peter Criss.
Hold on, dude. I'll be right back.
Ace Frehley.
I can still hear you though.
Okay. I am inviting you to Podcast Rock City. Let's see. You tell me you're in, and I will pick a date. And before you go on tour, we will all get together this way on the last show. on the last show of the tour, you guys could all get together and hold hands, maybe even kiss each other on the cheek, you know, and hug it out. And the fans, we as the children, can feel good at the end. Sonny Hollywood Pooney, what do you got to say about it? I'm sorry, Sonny. Go ahead.
All right. So I'll say two things. One is if the four originals are going to get together in the same room and they need a mediator, then I need to be sitting next to Ace because he's not going to be able to hear anything anyway. So when somebody takes a shot at him, I'm just going to say, he said he loves you. Oh, I love you too, man. You know, so he's not going to be able to hear anything, right? That's the only way. I'm usually the morbid one on this thing. It's going to take somebody to die for the others to get back there.
Oh, why do you do that to me?
I'm just telling
you. My heart's going to beat.
This is true in your personal life, too, is if you had a group of friends from 20 years ago, which I can think of right now, that I had a group of friends that were really, really super tight, about 20 years ago, and they've went on to, you know, live their lives or whatever. Maybe it was more like 15 years ago. And it wasn't until somebody died in our group of friends that we got back together. And it's possibly it won't happen again until something like that happens. It's unfortunate. But these guys will be at each other's throats until something like that happens. There has to be something that brings them together. It's not going to be a miracle. It'll be something like this.
It's money, dude. Money.
It's money. So, and somebody, Joe must be drunk tonight. Thank you. It's a little tongue-in-cheek. Let's make sure that we're clear there. Somebody said that we should do a Kickstarter to raise the money. Listen, this is important. If Jody and Sonny and I are going to do a Kickstarter for anything, it's going to be feeding people that need food, not something stupid like getting these guys together or buying somebody a Gene Simmons vault. I'm not doing anything like that. Now, I would rather feed somebody, you know. But however, maybe we can do a Kickstarter to get me a Kiss pinball machine.
Oh, my God.
I'm kidding. I'm going to, if we did a Kickstarter on this show, it would be to feed people or to house people because God knows.
Sonny's or to start a motorcycle.
Yeah, there you go. I'm all about it. Kickstarter. I get it. But I'm bummed.
Yeah.
Yeah, so somebody said I was drunk tonight. Joe, you're blabbering. Are you hitting the Zima?
Zima. Oh, my God. That's the old Truly right there.
Yeah, with like a little cherry in it. Yeah,
I was like five Zimas to the wind one time when we did a show. That's why everybody's.
The time before that, it was Purple Passion.
Yeah, I used to use that as a chaser. I drink one to a bottle of Jack or something.
That's awesome.
Dude, back in the 90s, every single girl at every bar, Zima, 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 all day long. It's crazy. Shit was horrible.
Now, see, you got people here saying, I don't think Paul or Gene are willing to go down that road. We're not talking about a road. We're talking about a cul-de-sac. You see, you drive down it to the cul-de-sac represents the end of everything. They come to it, and they circle it maybe once, and then they leave. Like, one, yeah, okay. Now, I did get messages on my, on Wednesday, I talked about them getting together and doing one final, you know, song for us. And of course, you know, people were like, you're delirious, Joe. It's never going to happen. And I'm like, look, I know it's not going to happen. That's why I'm saying the things I'm saying, because it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous that four guys who have made millions of dollars together can't go, you know, we worked for our money, and they did. When people go, I bought them that house, I paid for that. No, you didn't. They paid for the house. You paid for the things they were offering. However, being a loyal fan is worth something. Sonny, what do you think? True?
Oh, yeah. It's definitely worth something. I was thinking there's a way for them to do like a song together. But here's how most likely it would have to be. It would have to be like they're doing giving the proceeds to, let's say, veterans. Right? Peter, put a drum track down. Here's the backing vocals we want you to put on. Ace, do a solo. Here, do a rhythm track. Do some backing vocals. And Paul controls it all. But then you have to live with whatever I cut out, whatever I auto-tune. If I don't use your drum track, don't be all bitchy about it. If I use somebody else's solo, too bad. But there'll be a piece of you in it. Nobody gets any money, and we're giving all the proceeds to veterans. That's the only way I see something like that happen. Because Ace and Peter most likely would do something with them if they knew Paul and Gene weren't making money either.
Okay, now so we're driving down the river or what would we call that?
That's a road.
You drive it down a boat, though, right? Down a boat, you're still driving a boat, right? We're in a river, and now things could part. I have other ideas. I'm going to go down the more optimistic idea, okay? So here's my – and then we're going to come to yours, Jody, so be prepared. All right, here's my optimistic idea. If I'm Ace and Peter, okay, and this is important, okay, especially Ace more than Peter, okay, I'm calling them and saying – you guys said that I am welcome on to come. I would like to play a song with you guys on the last show, and I'm not, you don't even have to pay me a penny. Now follow me here, because this is important. As Ace being Ace Frehley, he's giving Paul and Gene the opportunity to say yes, and then they're all heroes, or no, and Ace, he goes, "Now I tried to give you guys what you wanted." You see where I'm going with that? And Peter could do the same thing. Peter could go, I called him. I told him I wanted to come, and they said no. Or do you think if they called them and said, look, if they called and said, it's not going to cost you a penny, I'm going to get on that stage for our fans, and I'm going to play a song with you, they'd say yes, right?
I think so.
Absolutely. So, I mean, ultimately, now, if Peter and Ace said, all I need is a flight and a hotel room, they still say yes, right?
I think so.
Okay, so you guys are both the money guy. You guys have done record deals and business deals, and I've never done anything like that. I'm barely keeping my head above water. So so you see that these two guys could turn shit on them, right? They could go, oh, we're invited? Great. And then get with Metal Sludge or whatever, any of those other things, and go, we're calling them. We're going to call them this week and tell them we're coming to the last show. Forget, first of all, they'll announce the last show and it'll sell out like that. Second of all, you'll have all these people waiting. What's Paul and Gene going to say? You know? But once again, you guys are leaving comments on YouTube, I'm sure, going, this guy's fucking nuts. Am I nuts, Sonny?
Yeah, because that's a lose-lose for Ace and Peter. Like, if you put out the olive branch that way, that, look, it's not costing you anything, I want to come by, there is absolutely no reason Paul and Gene say no. Well, let's be real. Paul say no. It won't matter what Gene says, right? So Ace and Peter can't do that, because any lick of money they would make, all the leverage is gone. And just like you said, I'm Peter, I call Ace and say, look, let's just get on the final tour so we don't got to hear shit about weren't there, blah, 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 blah. Let's just offer them. We'll do it for free. The show's going to sell out. They're going to add a date. The next show's going to sell out. Ace and Peter are not going to make a nickel. Dude, there's no way. The problem is, every time that conversation happens, it's like, hey, Paul, we're interested in coming. Let's have the lawyers in the room talk it out. And that's when Paul's like, no thanks.
That's the best comment right there. The Vinnie Vincent box set will be out before that ever happens. Thank you, Adam NC, which I'm thinking is North Carolina. Thank you very much. That was a great comment. You guys are amazing. I still say you're nuts. See?
Hoffman's hilarious, dude.
Hoffman. You guys are really into this today. Thank you very much. 33 of you guys are watching. Don't forget, if you haven't subscribed to our channel on YouTube, go there. All right, so we're going to continue with this conversation and talking about the history of Podcast Rock City. Thank you guys very much for being here. But one other thing, this weekend coming up, a week from yesterday, Jody, you still coming?
Yeah.
Awesome. Jody and Sonny and I will be at the Rockin' Pod. Jody and I will be doing shows. Sonny will be escorting his wife around town. And I'm so excited once again, because, I mean, we get to meet Sonny's wife, Jody.
Right. Yeah, I know. It's cool.
I'm not even
she's
sure
real.
She's real. I'm not sure she is.
If she's spectacular.
If he shows up, if there's a woman staying next to you and she goes, remember, I told you no touching, then I'm going to know you paid for that.
Yeah.
I'm sure she's going to be there, and I can't wait to tell her how beautiful she is to be able to see her. Rockin' Pod in Nashville is this weekend. If you guys haven't got your tickets, if you could make it, you can come and be on the show with us, because we're going to be there, and we're going to do the whole thing live. This is it. We're going to try to do the whole thing live. How about that?
Yeah.
At the least, we're going to record everything. Jody and I have interviews coming up for that. I'll tell you guys, everybody that we're interviewing. Jody, and I wanted to mention this.
Are these the on-stage things? Because I'm not doing those.
One on-stage thing. One on-stage
thing. We know.
I'll, yeah.
I'll handle the one on-stage thing, okay?
Cool.
I'll handle that. But then we have interviews. Let's see if I can find our interviews. I kind of threw this. We have interviews with, let's see here.
Kerry Stevens.
No, we do not have Kerry Stevens.
Lita Ford?
No, I'm not doing that one either. Okay.
Any other girls that you might get upset or you might yell at you?
No, women yell at me all the time, except for Karen. We never had a mean word. Okay, so here we go. So we got Chris McLernan. Chris McLernan is in Saigon Kick, okay? But his Kiss connection is he was in Cold Gin with Tommy Thayer.
Ooh.
That will be live, okay? And that's going to happen it depends on where you are. But it'll happen at 2 o'clock, at 3 o'clock Eastern time. Jody and I will start interviewing at that point, and we'll be done an hour later. All our interviews will be done in an hour, okay, Jody? So yeah. We've got starting at 3, but so we're going to do a live thing with Craig Gass. I will do a live thing with Craig Gass. That'll still be on YouTube, guys. We'll make sure that we post that on YouTube and get it on YouTube. Then we've got Chris McLernan, who is in Saigon Kick, and he was in Cold Gin. Can't wait to talk to him. Then we have the Talisman, which will be amazing to talk to those guys again. Yeah. Because think about this. I mean, they were in Gene's band the last time we talked to them.
Were they? I thought they were doing the Ace thing already.
No, I think they were doing Gene at that point. Or they had just finished Gene, I think.
I thought we were asking them, like, what's Ace shit they were going to play and stuff.
Oh, maybe that's true.
I don't know.
We've got a lot to talk about now because it's been a couple of years. So, all right, after the Talisman, we have Christopher Williams.
Classic.
Yeah, and he plays drums in what band, Sonny?
Except,
yes. And he's super awesome, a huge Kiss fan. Man, that dude owns a Peter Criss drum set, right?
Yeah, I think
he has like two or three, doesn't he?
He's got the Destroyer one, and he's got the like reunion style one.
Yeah.
And he might even have like an 80s one. I don't know.
Yeah, it's totally crazy. Then after that, we're going to have Don Jameson from That Metal Show. I'm super excited about that because I'm going to ask Eddie Trunk questions, right? I got to ask questions about that dude. And he's a comedian too, so that'll be fun. Then we'll get a break. We'll get a little break. And at 6 o'clock Eastern time, we will be interviewing the person, the whole reason why Jody's going, Matt Pinfield.
That's not the reason I'm going is to see you and Sonny, dude.
I know.
The rest of the guys,
but
I am excited about Pinfield though. He's a legend.
He's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
As a matter of fact,
I looked it up, and I believe what it said was he got in before Kiss.
Wow. For what?
Everybody
just broadcasting?
Got in before Kiss.
Yeah.
No, I think he was in radio and stuff. But we're going to talk to them about that, man. And I think these shows are going to be awesome.
I wish there was Martha Quinn or Kennedy was going to be there. Tabitha Soren, maybe. We'll deal with it. I want to meet that Mark Goodman guy. I mean, he's a legend,
he's gonna
first
be
VJ ever. I mean, you know?
Yeah. All I can say is if Martha Quinn was there, if she's still adorable, we might have a problem. Yeah. I haven't seen any pictures of her recently, but if she's still got that little haircut. And
she's got to be like 60-something, dude.
Oh, no way, man. How old is Martha Quinn? All right, let's Google it.
Karen is going to punch you in the back of the head.
She knows. She knows. It's okay. Karen loves me.
Sledgehammer to the head.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. When she's not with me, when we're together and nobody's around, she's like, I swear to God, if I ever get a shot at that Angelina Jolie, I'm not joking. now she's gonna punch me in the head.
Yeah.
All right, let's Google Martha Quinn.
Yeah, how old is she?
How old is Martha Quinn?
I'm guessing 61.
Holy shit, she's 62 years old.
Yeah.
And the only picture of her, I don't know how old that picture is.
About 40 years.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't care. She's still adorable. Okay.
Yeah, so Joe, knock the dust off that shit.
Knock the dust off that. Okay, so all right, so now that we talked about KISS a little bit, let's talk about a few of the things that we've done here. Sonny and Jody, we've gotten the had the opportunity to interview all kinds of people, either at the Rockin' Pod, just by being Podcast Rock City, or on the show. Are you able to pick a favorite interview, Jody?
I liked the one we did with Eric Singer was cool. I liked talking to Michael James Jackson was awesome. First time we had Sonny was badass. So good we had to invite him to be a member. Yeah.
So good I called up Jody and I said, dude, I think we need that guy on the show. And yeah. He was like, I think so too.
Yeah.
Little did we know he was doing a show with some guy that didn't know how to speak English already. And
still doesn't.
Right.
Listen, yeah, and this
I told Sonny, I said, man, can you get on? We want to talk to you about something. We had like the whole proposition worked out for him and shit.
And
I thought I did something wrong. I'm like, why are they calling me back? I thought everything was fine.
Yeah, you guys don't know this, but Sonny is the only person on the show that actually makes money doing this.
Oh,
we
yeah,
have
right.
to pay him.
Yeah.
One other thing. Listen, Sonny, what about you? What about interviews?
Yeah. I think Mark Slaughter at the first Rockin' Pod, getting him for almost an hour. Remember, he just sat there with us.
Yeah, that's cool.
That was amazing. I remember sitting there going, Mark Slaughter's sitting right next to us. Like, why?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And same thing with me and Michael Sweet.
Michael Sweet. Oh, right.
Sitting at the table with us. I was like, holy shit, I'm sitting at a table with a dude from Striper.
Let me tell you something. When it was all over, when the show was all over, Michael Sweet gets up. He's so nice. His wife was super sweet. And they get up and they leave. And I look at Jody and we have like acid smiles on our face. Like we were tripping on acid for an hour and we were so happy that we just interviewed him that our faces hurt from smiling.
Yeah, so cool.
It was so cool, man. For me, I have to be honest, I've enjoyed all the guests, but and I know this is a little sappy or whatever, but I really look forward to talking to you guys every week. You're three of my best friends. Joey was like, as much as I know Sonny hates to hear that, you know, he was the cherry on top for this show. I mean, really, he's good. He knows what he's talking about. He's funny. You know, Sonny is funny and serious at the same time. He's not afraid to say what's on his mind because I get the hate mail. And
Joey is a jalapeno popper on a cupcake, dude. Come on.
and you know, Jody, I mean, we've been through, I mean, a lot together, man. I mean, I will tell you guys that we have been friends and doing this show long enough that we lost our parents while this was all going on. Your mother and father, and then me, my mother and father. And you were there for me, and Sonny was there for me, and I was there for you. Sonny, you know, back and forth, talking to each other. You know, this is the kind of thing, this is one of those things that happened. I really enjoyed, I remember when we interviewed Eric Singer. Well, the first time I remember interviewing Bruce Kulick, I remember being sitting on Karen's couch. You and I are talking guitars with him, which probably was a curveball for him, you know. And I remember sitting there the whole time. I was just like, you couldn't hear me. But I mean, I've played on stage with Bruce Kulick before. Just one song, but I have. So I have had the opportunity to sit and talk with him before. And it wasn't like this big deal that I played on stage with him. It wasn't anywhere big. It was just for me and a few friends. And so I have had the opportunity to talk to Bruce before, but this was different. This was for our show. This was something we worked on, you know. Right. And then when we got Eric Singer on, that was pretty amazing. You guys might not know this because we cut it all out, but while we were interviewing him, he was ordering food from his favorite taco place, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then he drove home talking to us through his car. And in the end, He never ate, did he?
No, he said, the food's cold.
Now the food's cold. He just and he told us, I was having a lot of fun talking, you know, and that was really amazing. Keith LaRue was a lot of fun. Keith LaRue was amazing. Now, I'll tell you one of the things about Keith that's really crazy is that he was driving to Ace's house while he was on the phone with us, which was crazy because he got to some security gate, was like telling him who he was, and they were giving him directions to Ace's house. Of course, we cut all that out. That was like, hey, Joe, make sure you cut all that out. Yeah. I don't think he lives there anymore anyway. But that was pretty amazing. Like for real. Like, when you sit back and think about the opportunities that we had, you know, Sonny and I getting on stage with Tommy Thayer and Bruce Kulick and doing an interview at the Indianapolis Kiss Expo. I mean, Jody was messaging me, holy shit, how did this happen? He was like,
cool.
You know, and then
I really missed out.
Yeah, I had friends that were messaging me going, I turned on Facebook and there's Joe sitting with Tommy Thayer and Bruce Kulick. And it was amazing. You know, and then remember one dude gets up and he was kind of drunk a little bit and he started tell him about how you taught Ace all his parts again. It was like so uncomfortable.
The guy who got me was when Ace was on stage. Hey, Ace, you remember me? I saw you in 1979. I was on the fifth row at Madison Square Garden.
I gave you one of my CDs.
Do you remember? That was like,
he's like, Ace is like, what? Yeah,
let me tell you.
I don't remember what I had for breakfast.
I could hear a collective. Don't get me wrong, though, man. Look, when people meet these guys, you want it was personal for them. They want to believe and hope that it was personal for the band. You know, it's really hard for it to be because they just meet so many people. You know, all the time. Hey, Heather Thomas,
dude, we had Bob before he went all nuts.
Bob Kulick, right? We had Bob Kulick on, and unfortunately, he's gone now, which is really amazing when you think about the fact that we had him on. A year later, he was feuding with the band, and I think even his brother. That's really personal, and we really it really kind of upset us because but rest in peace, Bob Kulick. That's terrible, you know. And then, but we've had a lot of people on. We've had people on that have written books. You know, about the band. Man, Jody and I wound up in a book. Or two. And Sonny, he's part of Podcast Rock City, and some of the books were there thanking podcast. That's all. There's books. What the hell? We do this show for fun, you know?
We're in that Encyclopedia of Kiss, even.
We're in, You just reminded me of that panther in the, or is it a tiger? Exit stage left, even. Who was that? I can't think of his name.
I can't remember.
Somebody will tell us. But these are, and here's the thing. I want you guys to understand, and this is important. I'm not bragging about the things that we've done. That's not what I'm doing. What I'm trying to tell you is, this is amazing. Up until I started this show, being a Kiss fan was me sitting in my room putting on records, sitting in my chair and watching Kiss videos on the big screen here. That was it. I never thought in a million years I would get the opportunity to talk to Tommy Thayer. And, you know, it's like, I'll tell you this. When we were at the Indie Expo, I paid to get my picture taken with Bruce and Tommy because it was the first time they were ever really together like that. I got my picture taken. I'm starting to walk off. And Sonny being Sonny, he's like, yo, where you going? Hold on. We were the last two people, remember? And Kevin Jemsen, remember, he hung out with us that whole weekend. So it was me and Sonny, and he's like, don't go nowhere. And he did his picture, and then Sonny looked at them and goes, come here. And then it was me and Sonny and Tommy Thayer and Bruce Kulick and Keith LaRue all doing pictures together. And I'm sitting there and I'm thinking, I was doing my prison pose too. Remember I was doing my prison pose? Was really on one knee. And I mean, I know I'm a fanboy, guys. I know I am. But seriously, look, these are all things that happen because of Podcast Rock City. And might I add, because of the people listening to this show. Because if 13,000 people didn't listen last week, if one person's listening, it's easy for me to talk to you guys, but it's harder to carry on a conversation like somebody's listening if you know they're not. And, you know, at one point, you know, 13,000 people listened to the three knuckleheads talk, you know, in a week. It's like, really? And that's amazing. And it's from all over the world. And once again, I'm not bragging. I'm amazed by all of this. I'm amazed, as other people are. When you talk to Matt Porter and he tells you there's a guy in Scotland that listens while he's making his dinner, it's amazing to us, because he's doing this from a little room in a college, and I'm doing this from my basement, and Jody's in a basement, and Sonny's in the room that his wife locked him in.
Because we don't have basements here.
Oh, you don't?
No.
Oh, if you dig, is there water?
I don't.
Does it create a fault line, like on the ice? Like if you're on ice? I don't know. Okay.
I thought there's no water in Cali.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. Only fires.
Hey, that listener's right. Snagglepuss. That's what you're talking
Snagglepuss.
About.
Snagglepuss.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, thank you.
Like a creepy term for somebody. She got a snagglepuss.
That would never fly now.
No.
It's not flying now. I'm going to get phone calls. Between that and Jody's talking about having somebody tied up in the basement. So listen, also, if you're coming to the Rockin' Pod next weekend, man, we got these special Rockin' Pod cards. And I don't know if you guys have seen this. Jeff Trott, who right now, I'm going to let you know, is the happiest guy on the planet, because he found a KISS pinball machine for sale today. And it's beautiful, in great condition, and the price wasn't too bad. And he was actually messaging me to talk him into getting it. And of course, even Karen was on the phone going, dude, if you don't buy it, we're flying up and we're going to rent a U-Haul and get that thing. If you're coming to the Rockin' Pod, he designed these guys, okay? So these are the cards. If you look, this is when we were in Vegas. That's me at the – you can see they're at, like, Don Russ cards. There's Sonny. He's holding a pick that says awesome or a Poonie, same difference.
Yeah.
There's Joey's card, where he's like the Rocky Balboa of
it's Rocky III.
Yeah. And
that's awesome.
And here's one of Jody. Anyway, there's
all my Les Pauls.
With all your Les Pauls. You know, so if you're going to be at the Rockin' Pod, come and see me, and I've got cards for you. And it's awesome. It was just us trying to have some fun with everybody gives out stickers. We've done the stickers, we've done the buttons, we've done bags, we've done backpacks. I was like, you know, let's do something a little different for us. And we decided to do the cards. And Jeff Trott designed them. If you guys out there have a kid on a football team or a baseball team or soccer, get in touch with me and I'll get you in touch with Jeff. And he can make the most awesome cards. If you look, they even have like a puzzle on the back. Or like, if you look, they even have the bios on the back. Jeff Trott will take care of you guys. Just let me know. If we come back from the Rocket Pod, if we have any, if they have, oh yeah, that's funny. if we have any cards left, which I doubt we will, but if we do, actually, I saved 9 sets. So to give away on the show, we'll do that when we come back. But if we have any extras, we'll give them away on the show to you guys that couldn't make it. We'll do our best. We'll have a contest or something.
I just sent the two of you a picture that I was going to send for one of the cards, and I'm like, maybe not appropriate, because I knew Joe was going to send that elder picture.
Oh, I saw that already.
Is it on email or what? Where is it?
It's in a text message. I'll show it to you guys. You guys want to see it. It's Poonie giving the finger to the door knocker.
That's great.
He's giving the finger to the door knocker. I don't know. You guys out there, he doesn't know what he's talking about. So
that's great.
Now, listen. I want to say, I know. Look, I've been here the longest, so I want to say a few things, and then we're going to get everybody to say something. But I want to talk about the people from the past too. You know, Andrew Kiss, when we had Andrew Kiss on the show for the first time, he was 20.
Yeah.
He wasn't even 21 yet, you know? And we did the show with him, and he was so monotone but super funny. His sense of humor was great. And, you know, you get a little older, your priorities change. Andrew left. We had, who did we have after that? D-Rock, right?
D-Rock stepped in for a little bit.
D-Rock stepped in for a little bit. He adds a little something different. He adds Devil's Donuts.
Yeah. And just general filth.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
And then we added Sonny. And Sonny took the show. I mean, like, in all seriousness, and I'm not blowing smoke at all, he changed the dynamic of the show again. The show was one way with the original people that I did it with. One way with Jody, and it was just me and you at first, Jody. And then we added Andrew. Mm-hmm. And then Andrew left. We added D-Rock, different kind of thing. Then we added Sonny. Every one of these things was for the better. It was different and better. And Sonny added, you know, a dynamic where he is a businessman. He has been a businessman for a very long time. So it's amazing to me sometimes to hear him talking about, like, he's in sales. That's the business he's in. But it all equates the same to the music business, right, Sonny?
Yeah, you could write a thesis on Kiss. That's one of the things that interests me about Kiss, is you take it from nothing to this big thing, and you got all these people talking about it, and everybody has different opinions. It's just, Kiss is just so interesting, just as a hobby, that it's ridiculous, right? But when it comes down to people and fight, the infighting and blah, blah, that's the same in all human nature. And I've had the opportunity to work with thousands of people, so I see it over and over and over, so it's easy for me to kind of pick out. But what Kiss has done in their career is amazing, dude. It's just like any other small business getting big.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. I was in the car. Karen and I went out to eat today. I had some Hooters, and the restaurant and wings. And
I was gonna say, well, where did you eat at?
But I'm bummed. And when we were driving home, I said, Sonny and Jody and I and Joey could get together and pretty much talk about anything, but I don't know that we would have as much to talk about with one single subject as Kiss. I couldn't think of another band that has, I mean, it would take a band like the Beatles for you to cover as much ground. And the Beatles' career, it's not.
Yeah, it's like six, 7 years.
It's short, yeah. So, and still there's a ton to talk about there. Right. You know, there's still a ton to talk about there. And you could have I don't even know, I'm sure there's a Beatles podcast, but with Kiss, it's different. It is, it's different. Jody, through all, are you as amazed when you sit back and think about this show as I am, you know, about how far we've come?
Yeah, I mean, think about it, dude. For 8 fucking years, we get together once a week and talk about some band. I mean, that's crazy to me. I never could imagine that it would last this long. But, I mean, there's still stuff to talk about, and it's still interesting and fun, you know? And for me, it's like, I'm a Kiss lifer, dude. That was the very first band I ever loved. It's just, like, part of me, you know? So I could talk about it all the time.
I agree. Now we added Joey. During COVID, you know, we interviewed him for his book, right? Put out his book. He put out his audio book. We interviewed him for that. He was a fan of our show. He was a listener before we ever met him.
Yeah.
And when I met him in New York, he was so super nice. And then we kept talking back and forth. And then finally I was like, well, let's have him on every once in a while. And then we were all like, we should just have Joey on. He's fun, you know?
Yeah,
Sonny
cool,
was like, but 2 out of 3 voted for him.
I got outvoted. Damn.
Yeah. and he has just added something else entirely to the show, you know?
Now we got a famous dude on the show.
Seriously, it's you know, here's the weird thing is I just look at him as Joey.
Me too.
Yeah, even when I'm watching the show, his I started binge watching his TV show. If you guys don't know out there, he was on a TV show called Z-Rock, and you can watch it on right now. It's on Roku TV, and you can see it on YouTube, I think, as well. But it's a great
funny,
show.
Funny, dude. Yeah, it's really good.
It's funny. And look, I'm telling you, man, like this past episode I watched. Now, I'm only a few episodes into it because I got other things I'm doing, but that's what I'm watching when I'm laying in the bed. And there's a visual for you.
And, Joey's laying in bed watching Joey's TV show.
Doing the pinch and roll. Anyway. and Joe, you know, Joey is like at the last scene, I grab my water, I start to drink water, I turn around, and Joey is coming up. He's like in between some girl's legs. I was like, "What the hell just happened?" Let me tell you guys. There is an episode of that show where he's trying to become a nurse. You do not want to miss that. I'm not gonna ruin what happens or anything like that. But you want to see that episode at least, okay? And he's just been a joy. He had no problem. I always wanted to interview Chris Jericho. I tried and tried and tried. He really doesn't like me, but Joey is a friend of his, so he was able to get him on the show. He definitely doesn't like Pooney.
No.
I don't think he likes me either, dude. Remember when he reprimanded me? It's like, fuck off, dude. You know?
He came on the show, and he a couple of times, once with Quarantine. That was cool. You know, and we were the first people, I think, to interview them. I might be wrong on that, but I thought we were. And then he came on the show on New Year's Eve, the day after, when Joey and I did a show with him and talked about that. And that was awesome. And then he got Kerry Stevens on the show with us, which was way memorable. And I don't think you could find that show on YouTube anymore. And I'll post it. You guys can watch it. I don't care anymore. But, you know, just his friends want to come on the show with us. And that's fine. But if he never brought another friend on the show, I would be fine with that. I like talking to Joey. You guys agree?
Yeah Joey's cool.
Joey's cool, man. And he's real and genuine. I never feel like when he's talking to me, like he's looking past me or anything like that. I know that sounds weird, but I feel that way about you two guys. When we talk, we talk. And Joey, I mean, he opened for Kiss for a whole tour. He had a TV show. He's been on The Apprentice. He was on MTV. I watched that video of Joey was on that, what is it called, Silent Library or Quiet Library?
Was he really?
Yeah, he played drums on a guy and was like hitting him in the nuts and on the belly and on the boobs and nice. Trying to make people laugh. I mean, but that, you know, Joey's had an amazing career, and it's hard. I strike that, delete. It's easy for you not to think about that because he's such a friendly, straightforward guy. I'm not BSing, right?
Oh yeah, he's super cool, man. Laid back, like you said, he doesn't come off as some like famous dude. He's down to earth.
Look, that's the best comment of the night, right there. Kiss Joey's is the eye candy of this House of Horrors cast.
Kiss is an interesting a band because most folks that I know that are Kiss fans, there's not much else I have in common with them. Right? So I know hardcore Kiss fans just like me, but they love grunge. I fucking hate grunge. Right? Or there's these Kiss fans like Joey who've done all this stuff in the music business. Dude, I don't even know how to get to a movie theater, basically. Like there's just or Jody, like I don't listen to almost any of the other music that Jody listens to, but right. For some reason we intersect at Kiss. So it's just so interesting that
it is weird
that happens, right? Because even like with Steven on my other podcast, there's a lot of the music he listens to I absolutely hate, but then we kind of meet at Kiss.
Right.
Yeah, that with Steven, that stuff that he listens to, like Taylor Swift and that new country, it's out with me. I I draw
I like
the
Taylor.
Line. I drive the I like Taylor too, but I draw the line at that new country stuff, which he's singing that song to me one time. He's like, I wanna kiss a girl, and I was like, I don't think so. I'm gonna pass on that. And he was now let's talk about Steven. Man, we met Steven through Sonny, because Sonny was doing a podcast with him. And to be fair, Steven's awful, but his wife, she's amazing.
Yeah, Jen's totally cool. Steven,
Jen is amazing. And
you guys are going to be saying the same thing this coming week, too. It's like, Nicole, do you know anything about Kiss, possibly? Because we'd like to swap out.
Yeah.
She's going to say, who's Kiss?
Right.
Now, how many times have you had the opportunity to take Nicole to see Kiss?
Just once, because there's a story. She's not the biggest Kiss fan on the planet. One, because that's not the type of music she listens to. But there's a whole other story that has to do with our son. Kiss was on the farewell tour. And there was the first leg I went on, right, which was in March. They came through here in March. And she was 4 months pregnant. And I wanted to go see him. Everything was fine. I went to, you know, Sacramento and Reno, blah, 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 blah. But then the second time they came around, the date was July 30th. And Anthony was due July 31st, August 1st. So I still kind of talked her into going. Because I'm like, it's a farewell tour, babe. They're never coming back.
Yeah.
Now, that was 18 awesome. Years ago.
And her water broke, and we were running out of the place.
And Anthony turned 21 today, by the way.
Holy mackerel. Right.
Good birthday, Anthony.
That is crazy. August babies.
Yeah.
My son turned 16. Look at that. Two monumental birthdays.
Yeah.
My
That's
son
crazy.
Turned 16 on next Sunday. I'm leaving
Good
the Rockin'
Lord.
Pod. I'm leaving the Rockin' Pod. First thing in the morning on Sunday, driving back here, picking him up, and taking him to the Atlanta Comic Con because, you know, it's his birthday, and we gotta blow it out, right?
Totally.
Gosh,
he's turning 16, though? That's so crazy to me.
He got his
I remember when he
birthday.
Was like a little tiny baby.
He was 8 when we started.
Yeah, that's crazy.
And it really is amazing, and it's just mind-blowing. Let's talk about people that we've met. Matt Porter is amazing. I love Matt Porter.
Me too.
He is quite possibly the friendliest, person I've ever met in my entire life. Just smiles the minute you see him, and it's genuine, and he means it. And his show is great, and he's been doing it for a long time. And you know, I had the opportunity to go up there and meet him, and I could write a movie about that. It was so amazing, you know? And who else? Matt Porter.
Think about Brad Rustoven.
Kevin Williams.
Brent Zias, for Christ's sakes. We met Brent because of the show. We met
Mike. We met Mike from Classic Rock Drops, right?
Yeah.
Is
met the Big Bry.
He lives there, so I would hope so.
Oh, he does?
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, he lives there. I believe he lives in Nashville. I'm not 100% on that, but I believe so. Hey, man, Mike, we barely knew each other. He called me up and goes, hey, my wife can't go see Peter Chris's last show. You want to go? And I flew up there, and Mike and I, we went and saw Peter. I mean, all these things happen because of this show, and it's really amazing to me. And I don't want to leave anybody out. The truth is, we met Lee, who lives all the way in Canada, and he came all the way down. He does a Springsteen show, and we met him at the Rockin' Pod, and he was he's a huge Kiss fan, but a Springsteen I think is first.
I think so too. He doesn't have any Springsteen tattoos though.
That he did himself.
Yeah, he does have some sweet Kiss ones.
But like, you know, the famous people aside, the people we grew up with, meeting them or talking to them, that's been awesome. Meeting people, other podcasters, has been pretty amazing. It's been amazing. And I've gone places and seen things and done things that I would have never had the opportunity to do had it not been that I started this show, and that you guys and everybody before you helped me get started and helped me keep going. And that's amazing. And I think, we don't get paid for this at all. We do this for fun. And I just want to thank everybody that listens. I really, really, really mean it. I know it sounds so cliche, but it's like every week I'm able to look out and I get to see, 10, 20, 30,000 of our friends are listening to our conversation, maybe yelling at us a little bit sometimes, but it really is an amazing thing.
It is. We met a lot of cool people, a lot of cool listeners, like at those various events we've been to, we get to sit with them and do whatever we're going to do, Sweet 16s or whatever. It's always a blast, dude. It's cool to like connect to people that actually listen. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And
I love that.
It really is. And Jody went to see Ace and Gene play together in, where were you, Minnesota?
Yeah, Minneapolis.
In Minneapolis. And there was, and you met some people there that listened, that weren't listening to the show. And you just walked over and talked to them and they became a listener.
Yeah. Dylan and, what's the other guy's name? I can't even think of his damn name right now. But they're listening right now.
It's amazing to me. It's amazing.
Oh, it's Marley Cardova. That's right.
What about Metal Up Your Podcast?
Yeah.
Those guys, they do a great Metallica podcast.
Yeah. And, Brett Wells, dude, that guy's fucking awesome.
I'm just saying this. This has just been one of those really amazing things. And we can't leave out Chris Sinzak and Aaron Camaro.
Yeah, or Adam. He used to archive the live show.
Yeah. It's just really...
Yeah, he helped us out a lot on Wednesday nights with Brent and everything. Because Brent, he put a lot of work into that show on Wednesday nights, the radio show.
Let's not leave Brent out. Okay?
No,
I want to make sure I leave Brent. I talk to Brent. Brent has come to Atlanta and a couple of times for a week at a time and made sure that he came and saw and spent time with me. And he took over the radio show and he just sent me a message one day and was like, I love what you guys do. I just want to be a part of it. And, we just said, here you go. Go for it, man. And you guys did that for about what, a year or two?
Yeah, we were, dude, he had interviews set up from UK. I think we talked to some guy in Australia or something. Like we were talking to some serious people. Is that where we talked to Todd Kearns, or do we do that on the podcast?
We did that on the podcast.
We did that one on the podcast.
And remember we did that on the podcast, and he was just recording with Slash at the earlier, yeah. And he was at the studio, I think, for that new record, which was.
I remember that, Alex. Sorry, dude. I typically don't look at my phone that often. I wish we could have hooked up, though. That would have been cool. I was trying to meet Ace afterwards.
Yeah, John Clark's talking about getting together on the Kiss Cruise with the fans for a Q&A. We'll be talking to people on the Kiss Cruise probably the entire time. Because I'll tell you, like, there's maybe three or four bands I really want to see on the cruise. Besides that, I'm really going for the hang. So it's all about talking to listeners and just talking to friends, no doubt.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And one of the cool things is the opportunity to sit down and eat dinner and lunch or whatever. Hey, you want to go get coffee? Hey, you need a drink? Let's go get something to drink. And we go and just sit and chill. And it's, of course, it's not always Kiss, that you're talking about. It's just about music. John, it's StreamYard that we use. I hope you're not asking me because it sucks.
John would tell you if it sucks.
Yeah, there was a lot of work for Brent to keep up the podcast show.
Yeah,
and I think
too much for me and Joe. We quit.
I think it was John that we talked to while Kiss was in Japan, and John called us from Japan on the radio show. If I have that right,
amazing. That's amazing. I mean. That's the other thing. I have seen Kiss with every one of you guys now. Now, I've seen, I didn't technically sit next to Joey, but we were both at Madison Square Garden together. And we were at a pre-party together, and he came by the apartment that Karen had and rented for us in New York, and we hung out, and then we went to a party. And, I mean, Joey and I walked through New York hanging out, and right after that, we went to Madison Square Garden and saw Kiss. And then Sonny and I were in Vegas with so many of you guys that made the trip. It was amazing. We did a podcast in the room, remember? We set up one microphone and we talked about it. And surprisingly, nobody had anything bad to say about that night, did they?
No, the only funky part was there was no opener.
No remember? Opener, yes.
Yeah, remember? It was like, where the hell's the painter?
They Where's didn't have the painter guy? Yeah. And then I told Karen one day, I was like, look, Kiss is going to be in St. Louis. And then I didn't know about COVID, but I just thought this is my last chance to see Kiss with Jody. This has to happen. She's like, you know what? You're right. We went online. Jody and I were going to sit on the lawn. And I was like, I can't see Kiss with Jody sitting on the lawn. And Karen was like, you're right. Let's see what we can find. And we got great tickets. We sang songs. We were hoarse at the end. I got great video of Jody and I singing Rock and Roll All Night with confetti falling all over us. Yeah. What an awesome night that was. We hung out with Joe Lascon and his family afterwards.
Yeah, that's great.
That was a lot of fun. A guy walked over and put a hat on my head, and I thought for sure I was going to get lice, but thank God I didn't. And but I didn't. I might have even asked. I don't remember. But
he put that hat on your head to pay you back for the key you were singing in during the concert. That's what that was.
Maybe that is a complete and total possibility. Yeah. But you know, now I'm going on the Kiss cruise again, and Sonny's going to be there, and I think that's awesome. I really am glad he's going to experience that. It's a lot of he's done cruises before. It's not like this is new to him. And the Kiss cruise might even be a letdown for him, except for the fact that Karen will be there, and that'll be fun.
Oh, well then, whatever.
There you go. Hey. It's fun. Karen will be like, you know, the drinks are free, and Sonny doesn't drink anymore, so Sonny will help me carry Karen. I'm kidding. She doesn't drink that much.
And the cruise got better. Is Rat canceled and Night Ranger got added? I'm like, oh, bonus.
Bonus. I like Night Ranger.
Yeah, they're all right.
They're all right, man.
Better than Rat.
I still would have liked to have seen Rat, but that's fine. I'm fine with whoever.
I saw Rat back in the day, dude, and they were even good then.
Nope.
I saw Rat, and I want to say that Robin Crosby was singing like this. And oh, look, see, Joe is again. That's right. I stood right next to Jared and sang a bunch of songs.
Jared and I were at the listening party for Bob Kulick's solo album, that Skeletons in the Closet thing. Because Jared came out. Oh wait, was it for that or? Oh no, it was. He was at. This Kiss Night in Vegas thing. That's what it was. Kiss Night in Vegas during my birthday. That's right.
Yeah. And how we've just met all of these friends, and you guys have all been awesome. It's impossible to name you all, but thank you very much for doing this show. And I know it might seem like I'm rambling or that I'm excited, but the truth is that I'm
rambling
honored.
And excited.
I am, but I'm so honored that you guys and so many of you guys have spent your week with us for 8 years. And there have been times when it was harder for us to put on shows because life as an adult, it never stops, you know, and things happen and you got to take time off sometimes. And it's been, but we have done our best to, I mean, I don't know. This is show like 330 maybe or 35 and yeah. if you think about that's a lot of weeks of shows and we've just done the best and like I said I feel I guess that's Joey right there. Is that Joey?
Yeah, I'm assuming so.
Yeah. We love you, buddy. We love you. We already said bad things about you.
Yeah. Wish you were here, Joey. Oh, let me ask you guys real quick, since none of you guys responded. Did you see that clip that I sent you of Eric Carr? Is it Eric Carr? Did you guys get the picture or no?
It was a picture. I have no idea. I don't think it was.
No?
When I saw it, I didn't think it was.
I thought it was.
But there's no way to tell.
I mean, he would have been around at the same time in the same area. And I'm sure he saw the Dolls, too. Everybody that liked rock and roll went to see the Dolls if they lived in New York.
No, that's true.
It looks like him to me. It looks exactly like his chin.
Did you?
I wish I had that photo. I could post it up for you guys, but I don't have it on this computer.
Did you? What about that picture that you did of us all in Animalized?
Did you like that? I thought maybe that should be our new Facebook.
Did I look good?
Oh, yeah, you did. Joe, you look really good in that.
I thought you were a good Bruce, though, Sonny.
It was truly amazing. Did you say you put that on Facebook or no?
I will. I was talking about maybe having it be our, like, that banner or whatever.
Yeah, truly.
Since we've had that one for a couple years now.
Yeah, that's the other thing. You know, we don't take ourselves very seriously on this show. We're here to just have some fun, talk Kiss. Sonny has informed me and taught me how wrong I was probably 90 times in the 4 years he's been on. He has said something, and I went, yeah, he's right, but I'm not going to let him know.
Yeah. What, like Murder in High Heels sucks ass?
But and How the Elder is awesome. Just saying. We've talked a lot, and we really appreciate it. Next week, remember, we're going to be doing this live on Saturday, not Sunday. And we will release it on iTunes, the whole thing, the hour interview of everybody that we did, plus the Craig Gass interview, plus the everything. If you're at the Rockin' Pod, come over and say hi. You can sit down with us. We'll work you in somehow in some way to hang out and talk with us and maybe do a Sweet 16 or something like that, and it'll be awesome. I do want to say, very important to me, my girl, I know I talk about Karen a lot, okay? And that's because I want everybody to know that this ugly guy could get a girlfriend. But besides that, she is the most game person I've ever met, where I have said, hey, we should try this. And she said, we should just do it. You know, or if I said, hey, do you want to go to St. Louis? She's, I can't, I have to work. But you, that didn't mean you can't go. That meant you should go. And you know, do you want to go to Vegas? I can't go. You go. Do you want to go to St. Louis? I can't go, I have to work. You should go. You know, or I want to see Kiss in Madison Square Garden, you know, and she's like, let's figure it out. And she makes sure that I do have a problem with saying I don't follow through very well. you know, that's part of my problem. I have 100 million things in my mind at once, and like I've started things and projects, and you guys will hear about them one day. But Karen is the love of my life. I love that woman. She's the greatest, and here's the other thing. She loves Joey and Sonny and Jody. She loves you guys. And she has met all of you. And she genuinely cares about you guys and loves you guys as much as I do. And I thank you guys from the bottom of both of our hearts for doing this with me every week, every month, all these years. I'm not saying it to be sappy. I'm being honest. It's like without this show, I'm not going to say, without this show, I'd be in a gutter somewhere. It's not like that. But, I mean, I have, right now on the show, I have three really great friends. We don't always get to talk during the week, but when we do, it's great. You know, texting is fun. We make jokes with each other. We have fun. I have had other people on the show, Andrew and D-Rock, and the original people that were on the show, and, you know, all these people. I'm so lucky that, you know, when I sit back and I think about, I have all of these amazing friends, and I've met all these amazing people, and fans, and I would have nobody would have ever walked up to me and said, "You're Joe from Podcast Rock City." Of course, if I didn't have the show, and then I meet people, and I thank you guys very much. I really mean that genuinely.
You're welcome, man. This is great. It's fun. I feel the same way, dude. I'm not going to cry about it or like you might, but but yeah, man, it's great. 8 years, you're like a brother to me, dude.
We're definitely brothers.
Oh yeah.
All right, so we beat that horse off there. I know that's the wrong thing.
Whoa! Killing. It takes four hands to do that.
Yep. once again, thank you guys very much. Sonny, do you have? Oh no, wait, I always go to Jody first. Like I'm fucking up the show. Jody, do you have anything to add?
Nah, man. Happy anniversary. It's been a great 8 years, dude. I think I've only been here for 7.5 of those, but yeah, it's been great, dude. Thanks for everyone who listened. Keep listening, and we'll keep trying to do what we do.
Absolutely. Sonny.
No, happy 8th anniversary. It's been a great ride for me for half that time. And, I don't have anybody to talk Kiss with. So it's always a fun time for me.
And I was listening to some early shows, and I didn't always end the show like I end this show. I don't know how many I've done ending the show this way. And I always say the same thing, and I'm going to say it again. You know what I'm going to say? We love podcasts, and we love Kiss podcasts, most of them anyway. And you're going to hear the commercials for all the ones that we love right after this in 3, 2, 1, peace.